Okay, this is my Phantom 3. I'm going to test out some filters. We're all safe to fly GPS. I've got no filters on the camera right now. Calibrated the compass. We should be ready to just go out and fly around if we want. Shouldn't be any problem. But I do have to get the card, the placard for the filters. So I know which ones I'm putting on. Should have been prepared. It's a cloudy, overcast day. Alright. So we'll do a little bit of a fly around and check some things out with no filters on just the camera. As you can see, camera set to for a photo, I'm a single shot, image ratio 4.3, 4:3, image format is JPEG plus RAW, white balance, got that in auto, style, landscape, change to standard or soft, doesn't really matter, a little bit. Color, I've got it on vivid. Could go with a D-Log mode or D-Cinema, none, art, black and white, vivid. There's many more. I'm gonna stay with a vivid color right now. Under my settings, I've got a histogram going. You can see that down here in the bottom. The captioning, overexposure warning, I've got that turned off. I can turn it on. It makes a little bit of a difference. You can see overexposures on some areas coming up, but I can also exchange my exposure settings by turning the thumb wheel. Grid is off. I put grid lines in here and do all that stuff. Anti-flicker, I got it at 60 hertz right now. We'll leave it at 60. Quick review. Reset camera settings, whatever you want to do, it doesn't really matter. We're going to fly all of these missions the same, with the same settings. So we've calibrated our compass, our batteries are up there quite a ways. You can see the battery up here. We're on the battery marker. Get our exposure to the center, so we center it on our camera. Since I do have an auto exposure setting going on right now. And then what we'll do is we're just going to take off. You can see that we're at 3.6 feet above the ground, which is about where the drone's at. Maybe 3.5 feet. I'll do a little bit of flying around and change my exposure a little bit here. Just have a little better going on. Want to fly above the water here. The heron way over there. Well, we see the rotors tilt down into it a little bit. We'll tilt our camera down a little. Get us some exposure. Do a little fly around out here. Maybe we'll bring it back and we'll put one of the an ND filter on it next. And taking off again. So we're currently at 81 feet. Looking out at the water. See what we've got. Maybe we'll lower this a little bit. See if we can help this out some. Sidestep the drone a little bit and then turn him right. bring them on in. Just drop down here. About 48 feet. We'll start climbing the drone on in. See, got a big old log in the water there. Getting a little breakup on my reception, so we'll put the antennas down so we can get a better signal. 36 feet. See if we change our image ratio here, what it brings us. Oh, it brings them in a lot closer, don't it? And 32 feet, 31 feet, 30 feet. Still maintain line of sight. So go back up. So we got a little exposure issue going on there. Bring them on in. Bring one down. We're only like 7 feet, 6 feet, 7 feet. Circle on. Backing up. Let's put a polar lens on. This is the PL1 polarizer. By Polar Pro. Polarizing ones on. We'll see what that does. Okay, camera's calibrated. We're at height of 0 feet. And our sonar's showing 0 feet. So we're good for a takeoff, anyhow.
The home post has been updated.
Yeah, polarizer gives us a little different aspect. I'm going to take our camera down. We're still only at 13 feet, so we want to take him up a little bit. Let's go to 70 feet, 80 feet. But the water's still kind of cloudy. I don't know if I can change anything here to help. It takes us higher above the water. this like cloudy, sunny, do an auto, custom, and customize it. So now you get a real look at what our water looks like. We'll return to auto. It's really not a good day to be using filters. Our camera back up. I don't know, a little bit. You can see from our map here where we're at, where we're currently at, where we've flown before. Right across the lake. Oh, 76 feet. Seems not right with this. Oh, it's over the water, that's why. The sonar never works good over the water. It works good over flat surfaces and stuff like that. Then we'll get our sonar back. There we go, now it's matching. Sonar on the right is matching the stuff on the left. No, I lost the GPS lock. It was too cloudy. The filters don't seem to make a lot of difference, you know? I mean, they do, if it was sunshiny out, bright and shiny.